Hello, YouTube, and hello, Channel Fireball. What's up? Ben Werner here, aka Mr. Metronome, one of the co-hosts of the Lords of Limited podcast, and you are watching one of our Lords of Limited Showdown videos. We are right here, and we're passing directly to Ethan. This is sweet. So you should see my video first, and then Ethan's. You're going to see both of our drafts in this video, and then we're going to direct challenge each other and jam the decks that we drafted against each other in a friendly game with a little bit of trash talk. Should be some fun. So stick around, watch my draft, watch Ethan's, and then watch the games play out. Our rare here is Leonin Lightscribe, one and a white for a 2-2, Magecraft, whenever you cast or copy an instant or sorcery spell. Creatures you control get +1/+1 until end of turn. Card seems busted, we're probably picking that. Prismari Apprentice is also very good, but less good than Leonin Lightscribe. Commons that stand out, the Pledge Mages are fine, Silver Quill better than Witherbloom, I think. But happy with a Leonin Lightscribe here. Okay, so we're hoping with the Light Scribe, I think, to draft Silver Quill, but we also could be open to Lorehold, and we also should be open to pivoting off of either of those things. So this is an interesting pick here. There's not a great white card to pair with Light Scribe. Like, Pilgrim is good, I think a little less good in Silver Quill than it is in Lorehold, but it's very strong in Lorehold. Arrogant Poet is fine, again, but a little filler-ish compared to just the quality of something like Prismari Pledge Mage, or I think, for example, the Apprentice is even better than the Pledge Mage. It's very strong in a Prismari deck. There's also Emergent Sequence that we could use to maybe abandon this, go into Quandrix, whatever. I think this is enough better than Light Scribe here that we're going to take Sequence and leave ourselves open to multiple different decks. But maybe we're just supposed to take Pilgrim. I don't know. This is a close pick because this doesn't go with Light Scribe at all. Although we could splash the Light Scribe. It's probably good enough that it's worth doing that. Could also be some sort of Abzan deck potentially. I'm going to take Sequence here. I like this card a lot. Okay, and back on the Silver Quill train. So there's a Thunderous Orator here and a Closing Statement. Thunderous Orator is super strong. There's also very good cards down here. Elemental Summoning. The summonings are all very, very, very strong. Should be going higher than they are, in my opinion. Quandrix Pledge Mage has really impressed as well. Even in Prismari decks, you know, this card is basically just Spellgorger Weird, 2-2 that grows whenever you cast an instant or sorcery spell. A little harder to cast in Prismari, but still worth it, I think. I'm going to take the Orator here over Closing Statement, I think, which is potentially a contentious pick, but I do think in Silver Quill you need the cheap threats more than you do the removal spells. And this is premium, but it's not that much better than Mage's Onslaught or something. I mean, it is better for sure, but not to where, like, this is a premium 2-drop for Silver Quill. So Thunderous Orator, get in here, and maybe we're going to miss that the 2-1 Spirit that we passed last pack. We'll see. Okay, looking fine for us here. So there's a Fractal Summoning as a summoning in the pack. That would go well with Emergent Sequence, but I think we want to stay on track here with Silver Quill if we can. And also, like, we could be an aggressive Lorehold deck. We shouldn't rule out that possibility as well. So I think in that spirit, we're going to take Silver Quill Pledge Mage here. This is one Silver Quill hybrid mana for a 3-1 Magecraft. Whenever you cast or copy an instant or sorcery spell, it gains flying or lifelink until end of turn. This is, I think, close with Study Break, and then Brackish Trudge and Stonebinder's Familiar behind those two cards. I've not been impressed with the Familiar at all. I have liked Brackish Trudge okay, and I've seen it do okay in Silver Quill decks, but I think I want the Pledge Mage here. This, as a learn card, is good, but we have no lessons yet. I don't know. I think it's more important to pick up the good three. I tentatively put Sequence in the sideboard here. All right, so iTwitch is probably going to solidify me into Silver Quill. I'm a little leery here. I mean, we are seeing a great white card in Pilgrim as well as iTwitch. I haven't really been commenting on what I think Ethan's doing, which I probably should do. I'm trying to think back to packs. I've mostly been worried about trying to find my lane, which I think is important in this format. I think you're way more worried in this format about what's coming from the right than you are about what you're sending to the left. And we definitely haven't passed enough to where we're putting Ethan in Silver Quill or something. Maybe he values Pilgrim of the Age and he's going white, but I hope not. We've passed two Prismari Apprentices, right? It wouldn't shock me if he's drafting blue-red. But iTwitch in here. iTwitch is great with the Thunderous Orator, also works well with the Leonin Lightscribe, just curving out. And we're going to be on the lookout for cards like Essence Infusion, and even more than this, I think it's Guiding Voice or something, the single white +1/+1 counter with Learn. Star Pupil is good, but I don't know. Is it better than Essence Infusion? This is a semi-late Biomathematician. This card is not super important to Quandrix. Definitely less good than the Quandrix Pledge Mage. There's some Lorehold cards coming around, but they're largely junky ones. I'm going to take Star Pupil here. People have poo-pooed this a little bit, but I think we should be able to get Essence Infusions a little bit later if we want them. And like I said, I'd rather have the Guiding Voice or whatever it's called than the Essence Infusion. So I'm going to take Star Pupil and try it out. We're doing best of three right now. And I have, Fractal Summoning still here. We're passing a lot of good summonings Ethan's way, which is pretty unfortunate, but hopefully we'll get some of the other black-white summonings open, the Inkling summonings. So we have a choice between Eager First Year and Witherbloom Pledge Mage here. I think we're going to take Eager First Year and see what's up. I'm a little worried that this isn't actually open at this point, but all our cards go so well together. We just haven't seen the gold cards. And a lot of times I get a little nervous when I don't see the density of gold cards, but we'll find a lot out on the wheel here. Okay, this is excellent news for us. So Guiding Voice is insane, as is Rise of Extus, as is Lash. I think Guiding Voice is more important to the deck than Rise. I haven't played Silver Quill at all yet. I'm about 10, 11 drafts in, and I've trophied with all four of the other colleges. I have a sick Silver Quill deck waiting for me in best of one. I got derailed there. We're playing best of three here. My gut says that Guiding Voice is more important, especially with as low as our curve is and with having the Leon and Lightscribe. So let's get Guiding Voice in here, and then we're really going to be on the lookout for summoning cards. So we could take Leech Fanatic here or Silver Quill Pledge Mage. I like Leech Fanatic. It will also give this lifelink. Yeah, where'd you go? First strike, double strike, death touch, indestructible, lifelink, menace, and trample. Yeah. So that's one of the reasons Eye Twitch is going to be great here, because it's going to give our Thunderous Orator flying. I think we just want another Silver Quill Pledge Mage. I could see Leech Fanatic being better, though. Actually, I think it probably just... this can get flying. I'm going to take the Pledge Mage. Okay, so Silver Quill Campus and Arrogant Poet came back, and Pillar Drop Rescuer. So the 2-1 is missing from this pack. I think we're going to take Arrogant Poet here as a premium 2. Let's see, this is at the beginning of combat or when it attacks. So I can stack these triggers so that this gets flying first. I think that's true between the Poet and the Thunderous Orator. Don't love Mage Hunter, it's a little clunky. Pillar Drop Rescuer actually could be okay. Oh, wow. This is absurd and should never be happening. So we're probably the only Silver Quill drafter then, which is ideally where you want to be. Like, you're trying to navigate to a spot where you are in your college alone. Looks like Ethan is going to have a great deck too, but Closing Statement Wheeling is crazy, crazy, crazy. All right, Study Break coming around also. So yeah, we are definitely in the right lane. Honor Troll going late as well. I'm not sure what everyone else in our pod is doing, but I would be shocked if Ethan weren't blue-green or blue-red at this point. Archway Commons, let's go. We'll keep shipping the blue and red to Ethan. Cut a duel here in case we want to splash something. And honestly, we could, if we wanted to, switch to aggressive Lorehold. We need to keep that in mind as well. Speaking of, so there's a Venerable Warsinger here. When it deals combat damage to a player, you may return target creature card with mana value X or less from your graveyard to the battlefield, where X is the amount of damage Venerable Warsinger dealt to that player. Huh. With the Closing Statement Wheeling, I think we're supposed to just stick with Silver Quill. I mean, we saw some great Lorehold cards along the way, but Eye Twitch goes so well with our Thunderous Orator. We have the two Pledge Mages that are going to be way easier to cast in Silver Quill. I'm going to take the Apprentice here. I think it's better than Arrogant Poet. I feel okay about that. And then we're hoping to wheel Essence Infusion and or Intro to Prophecy. And we are going to need to be on the lookout for lessons at this point, because we have 1, 2, 3 learn cards already and 0 lessons in the sideboard. So going to pick the good lessons highly. They keep being the wrong colors for us. So there's another guiding voice. There's an unwilling ingredient. This is great, obviously, because we're trying to grow our things and learn. I kind of want the frog here to go along with Thunderous Orator, but we only have the one Thunderous Orator. So this would give our Thunderous Orator menace. I think we just need guiding voice here, though, and then we really have to put a premium on any lessons that we see. So Dina's excellent, not for us, obviously. Ethan took the rare here. Must be nice. So yeah, we're taking a guiding voice. We're hoping to wheel, I think, unwilling ingredient or Spectre of the Fens. Either one of those would be good. We're also going to be on the lookout for some combat professors as well. So guiding voice, get in. Okay, this is not the most exciting pack, except there is a spirit summoning, which is nice because we need lessons and there's not a card we really want for our deck. Silvercoil Apprentice is good, but not insane. And it's possible it wheels. If Closing Statement wheeled, it's possible that Silvercoil Apprentice wheels for sure. And then other cards we'd potentially be interested in, Stonerise Spirit or Pillar Drop Rescuer. So Spirit Summoning, I think, into the sideboard, and we're pretty happy about that. Need an Inkling Summoning yet for sure. All right, seems like people are getting the memo about Learn and Lessons. We're going to take a Stonerise Spirit here. We also could take a Cram Session, but we already have plenty of better Learn cards, and this is not what Silvercoil is all about. We could take Lorehold Apprentice as well, but again, we're pretty far away from Lorehold being good. So let's take a sad Stonerise Spirit here. I mean, I would take any lesson, but already gone, it looks like. So Stonerise Spirit, I guess this is maybe in the main deck. Ooh, another Thunderous Orator and an Inkling Summoning. Ooh, I don't know what to do here. Why are these cards in the same pack? So we could take Thunderous Orator or we could take Inkling Summoning. The first Inkling Summoning is very good. Thunderous Orator is also insane. And there's the frog that we could wheel. I don't know what to do. I think I'm going to take Thunderous Orator. Man, this is a tough pick. No, I'm going to take Inkling Summoning. I think Inkling Summoning's too good with the double guiding voice that we've got and Study Break already and us not having lessons. Okay, Inkling Summoning in. Lash is probably going to be our pick here. Show of Confidence. What does this do? One and white instant. When you cast a spell, copy it for each other instant and sorcery spell you've cast this turn. Put a +1/+1 counter on target creature. It gains vigilance until end of turn. Actually, that's sort of insane with Silvercoil Apprentice and with the Leonin Lightscribe. Pledge Mage also very good. I think we're going to take Show of Confidence. This seems pretty sweet to me, and I would like a Lash of Malice, but I really want to try this card out with the guiding voices and the study break that we've already got. And we're already in the market for instants and sorceries anyway. Holy business. Okay. This is crazy. So we're going to take Professor here over Clever Lumimancer. Lumimancer is really good too, though. This is just significantly better. And then Intro to Annihilation also hurts. I'm feeling great about that Inkling Summoning pick, by the way. It was a tough pick. And I think just the way the draft is shaking out, it feels like we made the right call. Really in the market for a Lash. But yeah, Professor is too strong here. And we should also theoretically just get hooked up next pack as well. So Silvercoil Pledge Mage would be great. Necrotic Fumes, I think, is going to be my pick here. The ability to go get a removal spell with our Learn cards if we need it to remove a pesky blocker is pretty powerful. I do like the Pledge Mage, though. And the Pest Summoning as well. I still think we'd rather have Necrotic Fumes. So let's put that in the board. All right, we've got Essence Infusion on the wheel as well as Pillar Drop Rescuer and Arrogant Poet. I think we just want Essence Infusion. We're doing okay in the creatures department here. And we'd rather stuff be instant speed, but I think this is good enough. we really need some flyers. So there was the black 2-3 flyer that we could wheel. We haven't seen a single combat professor yet. All right, Spectre of the Fens and a hunt for specimens. I think we're less interested in this here than we would be in Witherbloom. Despite it being good because it says learn on it, I think we're in for the Spectre, and this could help us potentially close the game out. So Spectre, get in. Thunderous Order on the wheel, magically, maybe? All right, Crushing Disappointment, no. Do we want Elocution? I don't love it. This is kind of cute as an instant speed trick. I'm going to take a Pillar Drop Rescuer here. I don't know if this is right or not, but I have seen Pillar Drop do some serious work in tandem with Professor of Symbology. Trading this off and then getting to learn a second time just feels really, really strong. So let's put Cram Session on the board. So it feels like somebody else might have moved into Silver Quill. I don't know what's right here. Normally I would have taken Star Pupil, and I still think I'm going to take Star Pupil, but I could see Arrogant Poet being right. We didn't wheel the Frog also, which is interesting to note. Take a Crushing Disappointment here and probably not play it. Another Spectre's nice. We'd rather these were combat professors, but given where we're at, we can't be too picky. Okay, so there's Necrotic Fumes and Intro to Prophecy here, as well as Guiding Voice and Humiliate and Rise of X2. So this is a very good pack for us. Sorry, I'll go back to this layout. I know it's hard to see in that other layout, but I really need to see my curve as Silver Quill. Oh, and there's Show of Confidence, huh? I wonder if we're supposed to take Show of Confidence and try to wheel Humiliate. I've heard great things about Humiliate. And we already have the two Star Pupils and the Eye Twitch to Humiliate onto. I think I'm going to take Humiliate, and then we're likely to wheel something very good out of this pack as well, which is good news for us. So where are we at on our ratio of learn cards to lessons? We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 learn cards and 3 lessons to go get. What? And a Killian? Oh my lord. Okay, and an Inkling Summoning. So hopefully we wheel the Inkling Summoning out of this pack. We're going to take Shalai here because I'm assuming this card is ridiculous. I've played with Embros. I haven't cast Shale yet, or Shale, however you say it. Killian's also insane, but I think this is better, and maybe there's a chance we wheel Killian. We're definitely getting something out of this pack. This is Silver Quill dot pack. So let's get Shale in here. I think this is better than the other Silver Quill deck I had, and the other Silver Quill deck I had was very good. So we're going to take Intro to Annihilation here to try to get our sideboard a little stronger. So we're hoping to use this as a removal spell to just kind of close the game out, essentially, to where the card that Ethan will draw or our opponents in best of three won't actually matter. And then I think we want to wheel this Leech Fanatic. So let's get Intro to Annihilation in our lesson board. Okay, lots of good options here. So Pledge Mage is great, Mage Hunter's Onslaught is great, Expanded Anatomy is great, Arrogant Poet's great, Pilgrim's great. I mean, other good cards for other people as well here. I kind of think we're supposed to take Expanded Anatomy. We're fine on playables. We would like Mage Hunter's Onslaught. We'd like Silver Quill Apprentice. We'd like Arrogant Poet. But I think the first copy of this in our sideboard to potentially grow something and push a flyer through is really strong. So let's get this in the sideboard. Okay. God's Willing seems absurd in our deck. I would really, again, like Silver Quill Pledge Mage and Unwilling Ingredient and Spirit Summoning. Ooh, I still think this is probably better, right? God's Willing is so strong. And we're gonna be loading up counters on things, ideally. And we honestly might end up cutting this Pillar Drop Rescue. I think we just wanna stay as low as we possibly can. So yeah, let's get God's Willing in here. And then maybe we wheel Spirit Summoning in Magical Christmas Land? Probably not, though. Okay. Intro to Prophecy is a fine lesson. Flunk, I think, is 2 premium. Target creature gets minus X until end of turn, where X is 7 minus number of the cards. So it gets minus 7, minus 7. shrunk by the number of cards they have. So the less cards they have, the more this does. That makes sense, because you're failing if you don't know things, I guess. But yeah, we're going to take this as an instant speed removal spell trick to trigger our Magecraft stuff. And then we'd really like to wheel Spiteful Squad. Sad to pass Zimone here. Okay, Combat Professor we finally found. Holy bookworm. I really don't know what is going on at our table. Maybe we just had high-powered packs, but this is crazy. We're going to take Inkling Summoning here for the board, I think, over Combat Professor. But I really like that card as well. I don't know. It's tough. We have enough... Yeah, we have enough learning, I think, that we're going to take Inkling Summoning here. Sad to pass the Combat Professor, though, because that's probably going to be our only chance at it. So let's get Summoning in the board. Tenured Ink Caster, no thank you. I guess we take it, but we're probably not running it. Maybe? It's got to be better than Dusk Mage, right? I really don't love it, though. Wow, all of the Silver Quill cards wheeled. I don't know what we want, literally. Less excited about the second Necrotic Fumes in the board. It's between Show of Confidence and Guiding Voice, I think, and I think I want Guiding Voice. I think I want Guiding Voice. That was a hard pick. Wow, we wheeled Killian. Okay, so... After wheeling Killian, Guiding Voice makes me feel a lot better. And I know we're passing these Mage Hunters Onslaught, but I think we really are going to be okay with... we haven't picked up one of the Lashes. That's kind of a bummer, but we did get the Flunk. I don't know. Well, I'm interested to see if we're going to get punished for passing all these Mage Hunters Onslaughts. Which get Leech Fanatic here. We do have the Necrotic Fumes and the Intro to Annihilation to go get... out of the wish board as well. So these are like pseudo removal spells in a way. So let's get Leech Fanatic in here. Oh, we did get a Mage Hunter's Onslaught anyway. I think we take that over the Pledge Mage. Yeah, we have plenty of creatures and all of our creatures are very good. So let's take the kill anything dead removal spell here. This is the widest open I've ever seen an archetype in my life. So get good, people that are viewing this YouTube video, and learn to draft like me. Start a guild and have, or not a guild, a college, excuse me. Start in a college and have your college be hashtag wide open. If you made it this far in the video, leave a hashtag wide open in the comments. Okay. So gonna be a little interesting to build because we have so many playables, and we were even pretty aggressively picking lessons for the sideboard. I mean, we picked Inkling Summoning over something very good. Okay, so let's start with the definitely ins. So I'm gonna, when I have a ton of playables like this, I like to build the core of the deck first and then see what other cards complement that. So Willing, Triple Voice is in, Light Scribe's 1000% in, Professor's in, Shale's in, Show's in, Study Break, Orator, Eye Twitch, Poet, Flunk, Fanatic, Onslaught I think is definitely in. Humiliate's in, Killian's in, probably Apprentice is in, Triple Pledge Mage is in, Closing Statement is in. Okay, so now what else do we want to add past that? That's 12 creatures. Are there any other spells that we're particularly interested in? No, we don't need the Essence Infusion. So we just need to figure out how we want to fill out our creature curve. I think we want the Star Pupils. And then do we want to run any less lands than this? So let's look at our creature curve here. This is all very good. I think this is probably the Platonic ideal. Is that a phrase? I feel like that's a phrase, the Platonic ideal of a Silver Quill deck. I don't know why Platonic is in there though. And then do we want any other creatures? I could see Eager First Year making the cut. Don't love that though. I could see a Spectre making the cut. So this is what, 14 creatures plus the 2/3 summonings. So I think we're actually fine in the creature department. Are there any one or two drops? I don't want to cut the ones, I don't think, with the humiliate, just because that's such a strong start. I kind of like to get a Spectre in here. I don't think we want a Pillar Drop Rescuer. I think we just want to be as low as possible. Could also see Stonerise Spirit being better than one of our derpier twos. We don't really, all our twos are kind of premium though. So Poet, Fanatic, I guess like Silverquill Apprentice and Leech Fanatic are our least exciting ones. It's as one power, I don't love it. I do wish we had more flyers. I wonder if we cut a Pledge Mage for a Spectre or an Arrogant Poet for a Spectre, maybe. I guess we're going to have the Inkling Summonings as flyers on three. Maybe this is just the deck. I'm losing my voice here. This was 16 lands. I don't think I want to go as low as 15. I don't know. This could also be sweet with a Stonerise Spirit. We have ways to grow it. I think I like Silverquill Apprentice. And I think these are good. Is this just the deck? I think this is what I'm going to try against Ethan. I just don't have enough experience playing with the Silverquill cards to know, like, for example, if I should cut Arrogant Poet for Spectre of the Fens or whatever. So I think this is what my gut tells me is the most aggressive thing we can do. And I'm going to start here. And then if we need to change in sideboarding after seeing if cards overperform or underperform, we can do that. So let's get some lands in here. We do not need 9 planes. So do we want 8/8 is the question. We're way heavier white. But I still think we just want, I don't know, we're going to want a double spell with white a lot. Maybe we go 9/7, but we want Eye Twitch early too. Nah, I think we just go an 8/8 even split. So let's say this is the deck here, and we will see you in a friendly challenge against Ethan.
Need a way to re-spark the excitement in your TCG collection? Box breaks are the way to get your hands on cards from the games you love. Learn more today at cfbboxbreaks.com or check out CFB Box Breaks on YouTube.
All right, folks, here we are for my portion of the draft here. This is Ethan, also known as Lord Tupperware, and we've got a decision to make here. So Primal Command seems really sweet. I kind of want to take that, but I do know Plarg, Dean of Chaos is also very good. This is like a mini Svela, basically, on the front, and Augusta's no slouch either. And the fact that taking this means we can I've talked myself into this. Taking this means we can play it in not only red-white, but we can also play it in red-blue or white-black. And I think the fact that that ends up in like 60% of our decks, plus it's very powerful, is gonna make that the pick for me. It's a little awkward passing Heated Debate, Guiding Voice, Rise of Exodus. All these cards are really, really good. I think I'll take Plarg here. Primal Command is sweet, though. See if Ben lets us get the red or white hookup. I would prefer to play the front side, I will say. Okay, so now we see a pack of, I think the best card in the pack is Prismari Apprentice. I do like Lorehold Excavation quite a bit and could get down with drafting a red-white grindy deck, but like, I'm not supposed to second pick this card. I do know that, I have some restraint. So I'm gonna take Prismari Apprentice here. Ben took the rare, must be nice. So I will take the Apprentice and probably not wheel anything. A lot of black and green medium cards, like Fanatic. I mean, Pledge Mage is good, Biograph is good, but I don't think that the fact that this, I think, is the best card in the pack, period, and pairs nicely with potentially our first pick, I think that's going to make it the one for me. Whoa. All right. Well, I assume that Ben knows that he's just essentially like putting me into Prismari here, which is just super awkward given that we're like gonna play each other. Like usually you don't care about what you're passing, whatever, but he could be like hook cutting me a little bit. But again, I think Prismari Apprentice is the best card here. I like the Pledge Mage quite a bit. Mage Hunter, I think is good. Pilgrim of the Ages is one of my favorite commons in the set. Very powerful, but starting off a draft with two apprentices and a Plarg is a really nice spot to be in. Oh, I forgot to mention one of my favorite learn cards in Field Trip as well, but one of my least favorite lessons in Pest Summoning. So Prismari Apprentice number two, get in the deck. All right, the hits just keep on coming. So I don't know if I'm supposed to take... So I know I want an Elemental Summoning, at least one of, in my deck. I also know that I like Quandrix Pledge Mage a lot in blue-red, and it pairs nicely. Like, that's a really good idea about the deck, right? Two Apprentices and a Pledge Mage lets me know exactly what I'm supposed to do. There's a lot of talk about Burien Books being, like, the... one of the top commons, maybe the best blue common over Frost Trickster. I'm kind of interested in speculating there. The biggest reason I'm a little wary of Elemental Summoning is that blue-red doesn't necessarily get a lot of good, at common, get a lot of good cards that say learn on them. So I'm going to take Burien Books over the summoning here to start. All right, and so we didn't get the Elemental Summoning, but we do get a Fractal Summoning here, which I will take. Nothing else really good for us. I mean, I really don't like Battleseer. I don't like Soothsayer Adept. I definitely don't like Dragon's Approach. Campus Guide, I think, is highly medium. The best card in this pack, I think, is Honor Troll. But beyond that, and I guess, you know, Study Break, I guess, probably second because it says Learn. But we'll take the Fractal Summoning here. All right, moving on to... Ooh, all right. Speaking of cards that I do like that have learned, Enthusiastic Study is great. It's especially great when we've got two Prismari Apprentices, right? This is just really strong in an assertive deck, which we're likely to want to be in. Like, this is going to be a tempo blue-red deck if I can help it. And Enthusiastic Study is nice there. Not that, like, this is the best lesson to go get after doing that, but I do think this is going to be a good card for us. So I'm going to snap that up here. All right. Yeah, this is nice. Start from scratch as another lesson for us is great. Like, yeah, this is not a card you would ever want a main deck, right? But it's so nice to have access to this out of the board. Cards that I don't like that I've learned, first day of class. I'm not looking to run a card like this if I can help it. But start from scratch, I think, is going to be really good. So I'll pick that up here. I'd be happy with a Prismari Campus, but I'm not. I think that would be my pick here if the start from scratch weren't in the pack. But because it is, I'm going to take it. Oh my God, what a gift. That's awesome. Arcane Subtraction. So this is blue-red's best learn card at common. So I'm happy to get this here. Again, I would take the campus if Subtraction weren't here. I don't particularly care about having a second Fractal Summoning, but Subtraction is awesome. It's a little awkward. Like, it's fine. Like, it's similar to Curate with the Apprentices, but these combat tricky ones are a little awkward with the Apprentices because you want them to be unblockable, but then these aren't tricks, etc. But happy to have Arcane Subtraction. Happy to have two learn cards already. And then hope to get... Oh, I have two learn cards and two spells. I mean, this is great. We're 8 for 8 with, like, really good picks. And then we get this pack, which doesn't have anything for us, and that's fine. Is there any reason to take something like Eureka Moment? Probably not. Reason to take something like Rise? Definitely not. So I guess we'll take Eureka Moment. I doubt we ever end up in blue-green, but... We're never casting Rise. Like, we're either going to end up going, you know, we would go to red white or go to blue green. So it's going to be hard to pivot into something like Rise of Exodus, even though it's such a good card. And Excavation did wheel. Not that that's something I'm, again, I think the two Prismari Apprentices are just so, so strong. I guess I'll take Twin Scroll Shaman. I mean, there's a world where we could end up red white. That world seems so far from me, though. And this is just more cute than good, I think, in general. So I'll take the Shaman. I don't particularly love Reject, especially because with the Apprentices, I'm going to want spells that I can cast on my turn. So I'll do that. It's a kind of a late field trip, to be honest. I'm shocked to see that wheel. So I'm going to take that. Like I said, I don't anticipate going into green, but it is possible. You know, if Eureka Moment and Field Trip are going late, it's possible we end up in green. Doubtful, but possible. And there is a negate. And like I, well, negate and curate. Negate and curate. I have liked negate in this set. And I think I'm going to take it. So Scourge Colony, if we think we might go like green, blue, splash. I'm going to take negate. And the Honor Troll, which was the best card the first time around, wheels. I'm not playing this in blue, red. So I will take this. And we do get a curate anyway, and that's good. And Thrilling Discovery. All right, so. Oh, hello, friend. So, you know, I usually like to do just a little check-in with myself at the end of each pack. And for this, it's pretty straightforward. I mean, I think we want to be blue-red if at all possible. It's going to be very hard to imagine getting pushed off. We could end up going blue-green splash, but I don't really want to do that if we can help it. We want to be proactive with our two apprentices, and I think, you know, Prismar Command is just gas. The most likely scenario for this is deal two and then draw two, discard, but that's pretty awesome. Making a treasure if we want to ramp. Sometimes you want to blow up an artifact. I think this is going to be our pick here. Kelpie Guide should be gone. I would imagine Elemental Summoning will be gone, but it would be awesome if that could wheel. Pledge Mage or Arcane Subtraction, all of those are fine, but I think Prismari Command is going to be gas, mostly for the deal two, but deal two and then Faithless Looting is pretty sweet. Plus the gems, folks. Can't give up on that gem value. Oh my gosh, the hits just keep on coming. Divide by zero, perfect. Like, would I like Spirit Summoning? Yes. Would I like Frost Trickster? Yes. But Divide by Zero is perfect. Perfect for the tempo value game that we're playing here. And now we have three good learn cards for ourselves. And so we're gonna, eventually we'll have to start picking up lessons. Nice, can I do it here? I think so. I saw the Elemental Summoning out of the corner of my eye and then I was like, is there something else I'm gonna have to take over it? No, okay, perfect. So I get to pick up a copy of Elemental Summoning here, which is great. There's not really anything here I'm actually particularly excited about otherwise, which is good because we're getting late where the wheel doesn't really matter. Like you could play a Befuddler, but you hope not to. Oh, and a Kelpie Guide, a Pledge Mage, and a Bury in Books. I am inclined to take the two drop here. I don't think Kelpie Guide is particularly interesting for what I'm trying to do. I think I need the two drop creature over the Bury in Books here just because of, I mean, I have three creatures. Now, that's a little, you know, Fractal Summoning, Elemental Summoning. These are creatures as well that we'll get, but I think getting the premium two drop here to start the chain of just let, I'm going to wreck you with my tempo. Is where I'm gonna go. So we'll take the Pledge Mage here. Oh, and another Pledge Mage? Yes, please. Zephyr Boots, I mean, it's a good card, but I don't need it in a deck like this. And Resculpt, I don't want. And I would want another Elemental Summoning for sure, because grabbing that seems good, but let's take another Prismari Pledge Mage. I'm really happy with where this draft is at right now. You know, if we could get, I'm not particularly interested in the big spells life, but Frost Tricksters are definitely the kind of thing that I could see playing here. Now this is interesting. Wow. If Ben is in white, whew, that is going to be a late professor for him. And he definitely could be. What do I want here? So I think I want the second study over the second subtraction. Yeah, I think that's what I want. Okay. Well, so we get our campus. Wow, and a mass. Yeah. I mean, I'm happy with where I'm at. Like I said, really happy with where I'm at. But I'm nervous seeing the cards that I'm passing to Ben. But we'll take our first campus. All right. Intro to Prophecy versus Brog Befuddler. I think it's just the intro here. Like I said, I'm all about just triggering this and this. It's interesting to note that Plarg almost casts our entire deck right now. It's a little awkward with a card like Negate, I suppose, but yeah, let's go ahead and get Intro into the sideboard. And that gives us our fourth lesson, I believe. Now, Twin Scroll Shaman, why would you be good? think I'll just hate Dina in case Ben's in black green. Yeah. Kind of petered out there at the end. I mean, there's nothing saying I can't play Shaman in the deck. And we're not wheeling anything. Wow. So is someone just in... If Ben is in Silver Quill, he's going to be getting the hookup here for sure. Another Shaman. I think I'm just going to take the gems here. Or the progress towards my gems. I haven't crafted the set yet, but rest assured I will. All right, so a little light on playables, but the beauty of a deck like this is we can definitely run 18 lands, even with a low curve. Like all of our stuff cantrips. We just want to keep the gas flowing and not stumble on lands. And also a campus helps in that respect. Can eventually scry, Prismari Command, rummaging, etc., etc. If there's anything I could main deck, I could play this, I suppose, depending on what my learn lesson ratio is at the end of the draft. Biblioplex Assistant could do it. Yeah, it could do it. Wow, yikes. So I guess I don't want to see a swamp from Ben, because that at least means he got the hookup this pack. But you folks already know what he drafted. But I do feel confident that we'll get a good pack three. Ooh, what have we here? Oh, I got excited. I saw Quandrix Apprentice and I was like, I can play that. No, I can't. This isn't actually that great for me. Environmental Sciences is a fine card to grab, I guess. Teach by example. Is it possible that I want that here? Oh, maybe I just want Infuriate. Just a one mana combat trick. That's probably what I want. Yeah, okay. I just want the trick here. Tome Shredder is interesting as well, given that we have six creatures, but this can't really attack. Like, yeah, I'm going to have a lot of instants and sorceries for it to exile, but I think the Infuriate's pretty good. Let's do that. Alrighty, now we've got a choice here between... What does this card do? Vigilance Trample. When it deals combat damage to a player, you may return target creature card with mana. Ooh. That's pretty good. Let's go to the battlefield. Yeah, wow. All right, so for us, it's between Pigment Storm and Spectacle Mage. I think Pigment Storm is more important, slash this is, I mean, I don't feel like I'm the only Prismari drafter at the table by any stretch, but I feel like kill a thing, my stuff is unblockable, enables attacks, spills over damage. That's gonna be more important to me than Spectacle Mage. And I'm probably more likely to see, like, if, you know, they're both commons, but I'm probably more likely to see a Spectacle Mage down the road because it's multicolored. Man, I don't know what happened here, but I am, maybe Ben hook and cut me and we're all up in each other's business, but this is just stone swing and a miss for us. I don't want to play Make Your Mark. I don't want to play Square Up. And those are my two options. I mean, I could play Archivist, but like my deck really does not want a six drop. I guess I'm going to take Make Your Mark. I'm going to take this. If I have to play a six mana 4/5, then so be it, I suppose. Another Study, another Infuriate. Maybe I was supposed to take that Battleseer back in the day. Take another Infuriate, I guess. Who needs creatures? Maybe now that we've got Infuriates. Oh, and we've got two Enthusiastic Studies. Yeah, I'm sure folks are yelling at me about not playing that other Twin Squirrel Shaman that we saw. Yeah, that's actually not bad in this deck. All right, another Infuriate, that is. You never expect it. You certainly never expect the second one. Holy cow, Ben. Why did you move into blue-red on me? That's so rude. So he just wants to 0-3 his draft normally, but he's going to own me in the matchup because he hook and cut me. It's so rude. All right, spirit summoning is good for us. We've got quite a bit of learn. All right, so what do we have? Three learn, divide, double study, four, and subtraction. So I'm going to take spirit summoning here, even though I'm kind of shy on playables for the main deck, if I'm going to be honest with you folks. But having access to this, I think is good. Basically, I have to mulligan until we see a Prismari Apprentice. So the thing about this is, and I'm usually like, you should, like, this is when you should be jumping ship. So blue-green, I guess, was what was open. Yikes, am I going to play Soothsayer Adept? I could splash Zamone in my aggro deck. Oof. I mean, Adept is just so bad, but it is a creature. But looking back at pack one, I mean, we got the two Apprentices. I don't know when I was supposed to, like, remember we had, whatever, when we were 7 picks or 8 picks deep. All right, Pledge Mage is fine. We can cast this. Yeah, blue-green looking very open this direction. I mean, I remember I did say, I did have the inkling of Field Trip Eureka moment being late. I did have that inkling. It'd be an interesting draft to review and see if there was ever a spot for me to move into blue-green instead. I was just so excited about these Apprentices. But definitely feels like someone was in our business here from the right. Yep. All right, we'll take a letter. We'll take a letter of acceptance here. Sorry, I'm just sort of baffled at what has happened this draft. I'm not looking forward to facing, I guess, what might be a better Prismari deck from Ben. And I wonder if his plan the whole time was to hook and cut. But yeah, definitely got me here. All right, 19 lands that is, because I can't make playables otherwise. And I've got tons of loot. I mean, two Soothsayer Depths and a Plarg. I'm never going to run out of all my lesson learned stuff. I'm going to be fine. So let's go. We'll see you for the match against Ben. All right, Ben, I'm officially mad at you.
Why is that?
The old hook and cut. To me?
The old hook and cut? No.
No?
I stayed one lane the entire draft.
All right.
And I think you are not going to be happy about it.
Oh, okay. All right, I'll play first. Yeah, we keep those.
I will keep.
All right. Good luck.
Yep, you too.
Stayed one lane, and I'm not going to be happy about it. Oh, the old black-white.
Pledge Mage. Okay. Let's go Apprentice.
Mm-hmm.
Your go.
All right.
That's what I thought you were, because I passed you two Prismari Apprentices.
The two Apprentices, yeah. And it was good in pack one, and then pack three I saw like nothing.
Huh.
So I was like, oh, cool. And blue-green was so open in pack three. Anyway, all right, well, I thought you hook and cut me.
They did not. I would do no such thing.
That's not true. That we know to be not so true.
I was just practicing for the team draft.
That's what I was thinking. Maybe you're just practicing for the team draft. Jesus. This is frustrating. I don't have a land nor my second color, and I am, because I'm solo on playables, running 19 lands.
Wow. No.
So what am I supposed to do here? I guess this, but on what?
Probably what?
Probably you.
Oh dear.
I mean, isn't that good for me? That's actually a pretty good I forgot about you. You're a good one to go get. Okay.
Do you have environmental sciences? Oh. Okay. No blocks.
Taking 9 on the chin, huh?
Easy.
Easy. You're going to just play what? Essence, infusion, or whatever.
Let's go voice here. Doesn't matter. +1/+0. Lifelink. Holy cow.
You got
so many options.
Got a lot of lessons, I think, over there.
Knowing which lesson to go get is really, I think, a skill in the format. I think it's a definite place where you can get an edge.
Yeah.
Because it's just a huge decision tree. I think I want to go get this.
Wow.
Put this here. Target you. Lifelink again. Smash your back.
Super lifelink. I mean, that's good. It's very good for you. Okay. Let's go to game 2.
All right. We're on record pace.
Yeah, this is great. Let's wrap this puppy up. Got places to go.
All right, we're sideboarding after trouncing Ethan in round 1. And I don't think we want to make any changes. Feel pretty great about that curve from the deck. So, yeah, I think we're going to run it back and hope that Ethan runs a little better and hope that we beat him again. So we'll see you for game 2. No changes.
All right, so we didn't get to play Magic there, really, which is unfortunate. But also, I don't know what to do here. Like, am I supposed to side in a 4/5 against aggro? I don't think so. Yeah, I think maybe we'll bring it in on the draw because that's what you want. I don't know. I'm gonna leave it as is. Maybe we bring this in on the draw, but I'll leave it like it is here. All right. Play first again.
You got it.
Boom. All right, this hand is better.
Yikes, best of 1. Where's my hand smoother? Well, mulligan. Ooh. I'm going to keep this. And bottom this, I suppose. Easy.
Easy. La poople. Yeah, we'll start with Pledge Mage.
Pledge Mage. Online. I'm gonna go shale, or however you say this.
Put a +1 on each creature at the end of the battlefield under your control this turn. I see.
Don't kill it.
Oh, you think I have removal in my deck? It's weird. I don't know why that would be the case. Yeah, let's divide you by 0.
That's fine. I think. Oh, less excited about that.
Not that fine.
Deck, why you gotta do me like this? All right, so I'm gonna guiding voice here and go get. Really wish I had an environmental sciences, but I do not.
The secret's out.
Gonna go get Inkling Summoning. And smash.
It's a 2/2. I don't know about smash. 2/2.
He's gonna graciously attack in. He's gonna orate at you.
All right, let's cycle this, I guess.
Okay. Resolves.
And I will get Yeah. Summoning. Plurg.
Ooh, you got some cards over there.
Yeah, I have some cards. They're mostly lands. I have some cards.
Lands. I mean, it's not the most embarrassing thing to run 19 lands in this format.
It's not.
Clearly, I could do with a few more of them.
Yeah.
I'll ship it your way.
Yeah.
Okay.
Get your old tap two.
I wish.
I think I'm not supposed to risk Plarg here. It's tempting to want to trade with your pupil while you have no creatures in play.
Deck, please. I'm gonna go get an expanded anatomy, I suppose, and then discard to hand size. Feels bad.
It's my only way to win, folks. It's my only way to win. All right, my turn. So as you can see here, we lose Ben's, not only his audio, but his video here while he's deciding to discard to hand size. We lost the Google Hangouts call that we were on. So unfortunately, we don't get to see the end here in terms of what he discards, but y'all know the game is over here. We savage him here with the enthusiastic study, pick off his X1 here, and it's all but over based on him being stuck on two lands. So hopefully we get to have a good game for the third and final one to decide the match. So we'll see you for that. You weren't trying to sideboard anyway, were you?
I was not trying to sideboard. My deck is a smooth killing machine.
Yeah, as we saw. Well, I'm looking forward to getting trounced. We made it interesting. All I needed you to do was miss multiple land drops.
All right, I will keep this one.
I'll keep.
Plains, your go.
Okay. No star poople, huh?
Spicy Killian.
Ooh. Yikes.
Humiliate you.
Yeah, that is humiliating.
Get rid of your arcane subtraction. Tech you.
Okay. Looting machine online, baby.
Doesn't really matter what I do here, I don't think.
The confidence.
I didn't mean that the way it sounded. Wow. I was just trying to decide which two drop to play.
It doesn't matter at all what I do here. It's all so good.
I think I actually did mess up, though. I think I was supposed to play this one so that next turn we could have had this.
19 lands showing itself in full force.
Oh, no.
Okay.
Thunderous Orator.
Mm-hmm.
Combat. Tech.
A jupe, as the kids say.
As the kids say, I would like to pay two life. Take action.
All right. Bury Killian.
God's willing.
Oh, of course.
Blue. Bottom.
Uh-huh. Okay. Boop.
Killian down.
Killian down. Not great.
So theoretically, I can stack these triggers, right?
So I my thunder think so.
Order gets flying. I was trying to decide that during the draft. Regardless, you can just, worst case scenario, block my Thunderous Order, I suppose.
Right.
So let's try it. Attack. I want this to resolve first. Yes.
Boom.
Boom. Nice.
Science.
Pog. Then I'll play an Embros.
Oh. That was your pack one, pick one?
No. I got past that. Or got it in pack three. Maybe I opened it in pack three or got past it. I was definitely the only Silver Quill drafter. Yeah. I wheeled closing statement out of pack one.
Oh, nice. Yeah. I mean, pack two was flowing and I was commenting like, oh, I wonder if... wonder if Ben's in black white or black green. All right, well, let me see this nutty deck that you've got.
It is pretty absurd. I'll let you take a look here.
All right, so holy two, your two drops were cut off. They're too strong.
They're too strong.
Screenshot.
What is my last two drop there?
It's the apprentice, right?
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah, this deck is really good. And what's your lesson suite here? Intro, anatomy, summoning, and inkling summoning and necrotic fumes.
Yep.
Nice.
Yeah, pretty strong. I mean, it was, yeah, we were the only one. I mean, when you end up as the only person in your guild, your deck is just absurd. College, excuse me.
Yeah.
Dollar in the swear jar.
Demerits. yeah. All right, so here's my deck. As I said, so the really interesting thing that I want to show you here is the draft, I think, because I'm curious if there was a spot where maybe I was supposed to go blue-green. Probably not. This probably just got a little unlucky.
I was wondering if you were blue-green. I figured you were in Prismari, and I was wondering if you were audibling to blue-green.
I mean, I don't know what I was... So here's the log for you, because the deck is like, it's not good. So it's like... I went Plarg into Prismari Apprentice, and I was like, all right. And then I got...
That's pretty hard to move off of.
That was hard to move off of. And then pack one, pick one, I opened Prismari Command, which like isn't insane, but is very good with the apprentices.
But are you showing me the log? Because I definitely can't see it.
No, I'm not showing you the log. No, I'm okay. I'm just recalling. And I've posted the log here for you in our Discord chat here. And I'd be curious to see if you would have done something different or if there's... Because there is a point at the end of the draft. So it was interesting. I had Plarg versus Primal Command.
I like Primal Command there myself, I think.
This goes in three decks.
Yeah, you're
kinda
right.
Which is kind of why I took it.
Yeah. So Plarg into Prismari Apprentice, I agree. Into Prismari Apprentice, I agree. Into... I would take summoning over Barry at this point, I think, but maybe that's too aggro on the summoning.
Yeah, I mean, Barry's the new hotness. I don't know. I was trying to keep up with the kids.
I agree. I mean, I think...
And I think Pledge Mage is also reasonable, too.
I think Pledge Mage is also reasonable, yeah. Pledge Mage, maybe even more so because they give you outs to get off of it. I don't know. That's tough.
Yeah.
I think any of those are reasonable there, but it doesn't change the course of your draft, really.
Yeah.
Fractal summoning, I agree. Pack one, pick five. And then, yeah, this is tough. I think you have to take Enthusiastic Study with what you have mm-hmm. over Pledge Mage. And then you take Start from Scratch. I agree. You're not moving off for Biomathematician.
No.
I would take Fractal Summoning here, I think, over
a second Fractal Summoning?
Wait, do we already have one? Oh, yeah. We already have one. Okay, never mind. Scratch that order. I would take Arcane, yeah.
It's basically, I think the way that you can kind of get into it is like, all right, there's Eureka Moment 8th. There's Eureka Moment 9th. Then there's Field Trip 11th.
Field Trip 11th is big game. And you took the one Eureka Moment, yeah. And then what happens to you in Pack 2?
Well, then
Prismari Command.
I get Prismari Command versus Kelpie Guide, which isn't really even a versus. It's like, for my deck, it's Elemental Summoning. But like, because Kelpie Guide's not that good in Blue-Red. Like, I don't know when I'm...
Yeah.
How do I get... I feel like I see all the blue-green stuff in Pack 3. Because then I get, like, a couple Pledge Mages. I don't know.
Yeah, I don't think you did anything wrong.
Except play 19 lands.
Except play... But you couldn't have helped how you ended up with how that draft went. I think you were just in a really hard seat.
Yeah. And then Pack 3.
I don't know what else you were supposed to have done. You just got owned in Pack 3.
I did get owned in Pack 3. I agree.
Yeah, that's rough.
Yeah. All right. Well, that makes me feel better, even though I got a trouncing. Well, enjoy your nutty mono 2-drop deck. in the
I will. It'll be fun. I have two of them waiting for me. That's the same kind of deck I have in Best of One, too. And I think one might even be a little better than the one I have in Best of One, which is crazy. Wow,
that is crazy. All right, folks. Sorry again for that little technical difficulty there between round two and round three. But well, we appreciate you hanging out, and we'll see you next time.
Yep. See you later.